ವಿಶಾಲವಾದ ಮೈದಾನ. ಮೈದಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಆಡುತ್ತಿರುವ ಮಕ್ಕಳು. ಈ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟೇ ಮುಂದೆ ಉತ್ತಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಭದ್ರ ಬುನಾದಿಯಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಆಟದಿಂದಲೇ ಇವರ ಕೀರ್ತಿ ಯಶಸ್ಸು ಮೆಟ್ಟಿಲೇರ್ತದೆ. ಇವರನ್ನ ದಿ ವಾಲ್, ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ವಾಲ್ ಎಂದು ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಇವರ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಮೂಲ ಕಾರಣವಾಯಿತು. ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟೇ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಕಾರಣರಾದ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಮಂಗಳೂರಿಗೂ ಆಗಮಿಸಿದ್ರು. ಅವರೇ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್. ಇದೇ ಹೊತ್ತಿನ ವಿಶೇಷ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ. ನಾನು ದಿವ್ಯಾ ಪೂಜಾರಿ. ಮಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ವೈದ್ಯಕೀಯ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವು ತನ್ನದೇ ಆದ ಹೆಸರು ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲೂ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಎಂದರೆ ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟು ಹೆಸರನ್ನ ಪಡೆದುಕೊಂಡಿದೆ. ಇಂತಹ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ನ ರಾಯಭಾರಿ ಖ್ಯಾತ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟಿಗ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ ಅವರು ಮಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಆಗಮಿಸಿದರು. ಮಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ವೃತ್ತದ ಬಳಿ ಇರುವ ಕೆಎಂಸಿ ನೂತನ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಗೆ ಭೇಟಿ ನೀಡಿದ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ ಅವರು ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆರಂಭಗೊಂಡ ನ್ಯೂರೋ ನ್ಯಾವಿಗೇಷನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತವಾಗಿ ಸೇವೆಗೆ ಸಜ್ಜಾಗಿರುವ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಯ 9ನೇ ಮಹಡಿಯನ್ನು ಲೋಕಾರ್ಪಣೆಗೊಳಿಸಿದರು.
Of our own institute, and it's an opportunity for us to have the US technology in our armamentarium of neurosurgery. So this is what is called as navigation. In simple terms, if you take for a driver what Google Map does, this does to us in the surgical OR. Navigation, the other terminology which is
patients. It helps us to do minimally access surgeries. It gives us precision to the structures, delineates very well where exactly the lesions are, and we can do it with smaller craniotomy, so the recovery will be faster. And when you talk about precision, the morbidity and mortality is very less. So this equipment per se is an adjunct to giving better results to the patients. And this is the newest, give radiation to the OD personnel and all. This prevents us using any X-ray machines inside the theater. So this gives us all the data. I think a small rundown. I would like the application specialist to tell really how does it work. It's just a model which has been kept so that there is an understanding.
Mr. Rahul Dravid with us, who is also our brand ambassador. A very warm welcome to you, Rahul, for being with us. It's a privilege to our organization to have you. We are also privileged to have our beloved Pro Chancellor of HS Bilal here. So we have a cricketing hero and an evergreen hero here this afternoon. We also have Sagir and Anand joining us. So it's indeed a very a great honor for us that Rahul has come here and also has visited many of our other hospitals. And it is great for us because there are many things that are common between Rahul Dravid and the Manipal group of institutions. Both are dependable, ethical, known for their integrity, and of course, the best in their field. The best in cricket, and we are certainly one of the best in the field of education. So I think there's a tremendous synergy between us. And without any further ado, I'll leave it to the Pro Chancellor to say a few words of welcome, and then we'll hand it over to him.
Friends from the media, I know you are very important for us because here we are only very few people. This message has to go around the society, especially on the United South Cancer District, because our brand ambassador Rahul Dravid is going to launch this Manipal Arogya Card, which is basically to see that there is more penetration of health insurance in our community, which is lacking in this country. Hardly 15% of the people are exposed to health insurance, so we want to promote it, otherwise they spend a lot of money from their pockets. And as you all know, the cost of healthcare is increasing day by day. So it's very important that people are covered, especially middle class people and people below poverty line. That's the reason why we have Rahul Dravid to launch this Arogya Card, so that you know, more and more people will get involved in this Arogya Card, which is going to be launched by our brand ambassador Rahul Dravid. So we are very happy that you have responded to our invitation and made it possible to be with us in large numbers. Warm welcome to all of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here. It's always a pleasure to come to Mangalore, into Manipal as well. So it's very lovely to come to this part of the world. It's been a really good association with the, you know, the Manipal hospitals and the Manipal group over the last year. It's given me the opportunity to, you know, visit hospitals in Delhi, Jaipur, and now here in Mangalore and in Manipal. And you know, it's just incredible to see the kind of social impact that the Manipal group is having in society, the kind of transformation differences that are happening in the community. And it's, you know, great to see all of you here, and hopefully that the message Dr. Bilal said, the message of health insurance, the message of affordable healthcare being a possibility for middle class people and lower income people, is that it is possible. The message spread to a lot more people so that more people can avail it will be really, really helpful. So thank you so much for being here, and really looking forward to the evening.
Mr. Dravid has spoken about the idea behind this press conference. Essentially, we are going to launch Manipal Arogya Card scheme, which is a discount card scheme for population in coastal Karnataka and district adjacent to Udupi and Mangalore and Goa. So the details of the scheme is available with the press release given to you. Now, if you have any questions, we can start taking questions.
Many more some here, sir. First of all, welcome to Mangalore. Watching you live is like rewinding our childhood days. Big fan of you. My first question is here. My first question is, you are known for your partnership on the field with Lashman sir. You are a game source for Chetan. You have a partnership with Mr. Chetan.
I think every when you have a good partnership, I think it's one of the best situations to be in anything, whether it's in cricket or in life or in any situation. So, Dr. Balal said, I think a lot of the values that Manipal stands for is something that I associate with, is something that I are very dear to me as well. It's an institution that it makes me proud to be associated with an institution, like I said, that is does so much of its work for society and to make an impact in society and to transform lives in the society. And they do it through a level of professionalism, a level of growth, a level of excellence. That is something that was very, very dear to me in my professional career as well. So it's a partnership, like I said, I really enjoyed and something that I truly identify.
At the age of 17, you started reading a book called Jonathan Siegel. You said that it helped you to concentrate on the field. So according to you, the reading just helped you to concentrate, focus, and also you can do exercise. So that would be something about that.
Eye exercise.
I tried a lot of things.
But yeah, reading is something I truly enjoyed reading, and I started reading when I was playing because in a way I felt that that was a good distraction. Sorry, match aar mele room ke baad tera mele tension irutte ne worry maad tera match yena to yena kitte rally yena kitte to na book idre read maadta idra andre your mind doesn't go back to the match. So that is how my habit actually of reading started. I found it a very good distraction. And it's something I've enjoyed doing. So yeah, so you know, I think for me personally, reading was very helpful and something I enjoyed. And yeah, so it was actually all the more amazing to see a library at the university today, which has 5 floors. And the library I went to in Bangalore had, I think, 200 square feet. But you know, so it's I think you know, reading and learning and knowledge is. Something that is very, very important. Things have changed, of course, today. I think children have access to be able to read from Kindle in so many ways. As you know, my children sometimes are reading from very different sources and not only from books that we have. So which is fantastic. I think the more we can, it's just a way of I think of knowledge that is there through the years, through generations, being passed on. Means of doing it are changing with technology and time, which is fantastic to see.
I exercise about your uniform exercise.
I used to just do some yoga, and along with that, there were some eye exercises that some of us would sometimes try and practice. I'm not sure how much that actually helped, but it's no harm trying, is it? Actually, I need them as well. I just don't get it.
They have come on track in the past year and they had a very good domestic run. So at one point in time, we had a lineup of Karnataka players in the Indian squad. So how do you read the situation for Karnataka going forward?
Yeah, I mean, there was a time when there were a lot of players playing for Karnataka. And you rightly said, we've had some good years and we've had some slightly difficult years over the last decade or so, but the fact that we've won 4 or 5 titles in the last 5-6 years has actually been a really good achievement for Karnataka cricket. There's actually some lot of talented players, so while there might not be that many players in the national team, I mean, K.L. Rahul is the only one, and the local boy from here from Bangalore who's in the Indian team. But there have been quite a few guys who are close. So in the India A team over the last 3 or 4 years, Manish Pandey, Karun Nair, Shreyas Gopal, Samar, Gautam. I'm sure I'm forgetting one or two names, but 5 or 6 of these boys have been in and around. Prasad Krishna is a new fast bowler who's bowling really well. So 5 or 6 of these boys have been in and around the A team, so they're close, and they just need to keep performing more, slightly better, more consistently, and hopefully their opportunities will come. But more importantly, as a team, it's nice to see Karnataka succeed. It's good they won the T20 tournament this year. It's a pity they couldn't make the final of the Ranji Trophy, but But hopefully, you know, they're getting close. They've made 2 semi-finals now, so hopefully next year they'll, you know, learn the lessons from it and maybe go that one step further.
People of Kosi Karnataka will get benefited from this Arogya card. Mr. Sekhi can answer it.
I'll take this question. Manipal Arogya card has been launched about 19 years back, and every year we are reviewing the benefits so that it becomes more and more beneficial to the cardholders. So this year we have one benefit which is very obvious for people residing in Karwar district and adjacent to that area, is the inclusion of our hospital in Goa. Because earlier Goa hospital was not part of Manipal Arogya Card scheme. And additionally, we have included lot of areas because Manipal Arogya Card is essentially the discount card. So we have discount on consultation, up to 50% discount on consultation any number of times for the entire year. Then apart from that, we have 25% discount on laboratory services any number of times for the entire year. And we have additional discount on your procedures, radiology procedures, diagnostic procedures, inpatient areas, multiple areas. We have discount ranging from 10% to 50% for a multiple use. And this year we have extended the validity of the card to 2 years, because every year renewing the card becomes difficulty for some members, especially senior citizens, because they have to come and do the physical registration of the card. So also apart from making adding benefit, we also made the card availability easier by launching an app through which people can download the form and then go for the card instantly.
Mr. Sakit,
the payment online also for this card, it is something even Dr. Balan said you would look into, and even your dean here and said that they would look into this aspect. So with this app, will it actually materialize that patient can renew his card online and make the payment also online rather than filling forms?
Through website, we have made the provision when you can make the online payment. But what has happened is last year also we had that facility, but somehow actually the usage utilization was very low. So what we felt is the problem that people are facing is actually in terms of approaching the hospital twice for making the card. So that was their main problem. Now they don't have to do that. They can just key in the information, and when they come to the hospital or meet the Arogya card partners, they can just pay the amount directly and make the card. So that way it becomes very easy. But having said that, our efforts are on to ensure that it becomes better by actually enabling the online payment system as well.
The balance of the team is very good, and hopefully that the team will do well. Now it is about performing, it is about executing on the biggest stage, and the team has been doing really well for the last 2 years. We are number 2 in the world, so that is a really big positive, and I think we can take a lot of confidence from our performance in the last 2 years. And hopefully, you know, we'll do well. I think we've got a good chance, and we'll all keep our fingers crossed. Thank you.
KL
Rahul is a very special player. I think he's a very, very good player. Chennai gaadi dane test cricket, one day cricket, T20 cricket, ella formats alli century hodide dane. He's one of those players who can score runs and do well in all the 3 formats of the game. He's learning, you know, he's improving all the time, and he's getting better, and I think that is very, very important. Hopefully, you know, he'll be in the team for a long time and get the opportunities he needs to be able to grow and develop. But in the last few years, you know, he's had some ups and downs, some good years, some bad years. But overall, I think, I think he can be very happy with his progress.
You being a Sunil Gavaskar fan, you must have beginning all in the batting style, Sunil Gavaskar hold it to. But end of all, 32 balls, 51 score, but his fastest score could have made it. He transformation period, he got it through. Yavritya precaution, and Yavritya preparation, you made it through transformation period from test to T20 batsman.
You had to do it, otherwise, the team will be here. Game changed from test cricket, the game became 50-50. Now even 22 balls is too much for 50 in one day, the way they are hitting in T20 matches. So I had to learn, and you have to learn, and you have to keep adapting to different forms of the game. I think you have to, otherwise you will get left behind. So Even we are seeing it now, even a lot of the players today, you know, they have to learn how to adapt. Even in 2020, it's changing so fast. 120, 125 strike rate was considered very good 3 years ago. Today it is not good. So you have to change, you have to adapt and move with the times. Thank you.
Branches of Manipal Group, is it applicable?
Career card can be availed currently at our flagship hospital of KMC Manipal in Manipal. Then Dr. TMA Pai Hospital in Udupi. Then Rotary Hospital, Karkala. Then KMC Hospital in Mangalore, that is KMC Hospital Attavar, as well as KMC Hospital Jyoti Circle. In addition to that, this year they can avail the facility at Manipal Hospital Goa, which is located in Panjim.
Rahul, your thoughts on Virat Kohli's captaincy?
No, I think, you know, there's no doubt that, you know, we've just won a series in Australia. He's done really well. Like I said, you know, we're number two in the world, so the rankings speak for itself. I mean, it's you know, when the team does well and the ambience, the rankings are in such a are so good. You know, I think a lot of the credit of that has to go to the captain and his coaching staff and the support staff that is there with the Indian team. So, you know, they should get credit for it. And I think he's learning, he's improving all the time, he's growing. But you know, his captaincy during the Australia Test series was, you know, as good as anyone I've seen.
And he doesn't mind taking on the opponent.
Yeah, I mean, that's his personality, and I think that's something about Virat. I think there's an intensity that he brings to the field that is seems to rub off on his players and his team, and I think that's something that's you know, why we've probably been quite successful, is that he's been able to get the team to rally behind that intensity.
I now request all of you to kindly take a look at the audio-visual screen. This is about the Manipal Arogya Card. Could we have the video, please?
ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಧವಪ್ಪಯ್ಯವರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಒಂದು ಆರೋಗ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದರೇ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂಥ ಒಂದು ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸೌಲಭ್ಯವನ್ನು ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಬಡ ಕುಟುಂಬದ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ ಕುಟುಂಬದ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಒದಗಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ.
ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದ scheme launched by Manipal Academy of Higher Education. The idea behind the scheme is basically to make quality healthcare accessible and affordable to masses of people. Way back in 2000, Manipal Academy of Higher Education started this scheme at Manipal, covering 5 hospitals, that is of TMA Pai Hospital in Udupi, the flagship hospital of KMC, that is KMC Manipal. Then KMC Mangalore, both Jyoti Circle and KMC Hospital Attavar, plus TMA Pai Hospital Karkala. So these hospitals are part of network which provide facilities to the patient who have got this card. And this card is basically a discount card which allows people to avail treatment in this hospitals, reputed hospitals, at a very low cost or a highly discounted price, particularly in the outpatient area.
We have launched it in the year 2000, and it has become very, very popular. And we have these facilities for all the Manipal group of hospitals, right from Goa, Manipal, Karkala, Udupi and Mangalore. The number of beneficiaries of this Arogya card, about which I mentioned, last year it was around 3.6 lakhs. And this year our intention is to enhance it to up to at least 5 lakhs of people, which I am sure we will be able to attain because of the benefits that this card provides. And the other most important thing is, initially the validity of the card used to be 1 year. Now this year onwards we have made it 2 years, because people do not have to come and renew it every year. That benefit we are giving.
We are going to introduce a new hospital this year in this scheme, which is our Goa hospital. So Goa hospital will be the 6th hospital which is going to be a part of this particular scheme in the current year. And we have launched app this year from which will allow the prospective card holders to enroll at their location itself. There is no pre-existing disease constraint for this particular card. There are a lot of advantages, including the fact that anybody with any age profile, including kid to senior citizen, can enroll without any documentation. Small card with big benefit comes so easily to the people because there is no documentation required. Anybody who want to enroll for this program can just mention their address and name and age details, and they can instantly avail the card. There is absolutely no lag time.
This has been a very successful scheme which has reached out to a whole lot of people, and more importantly, the kind of support that people require in times of emergency and healthcare needs.
We want to see that we provide quality healthcare at affordable cost. That is very, very important, so that a common man also can afford to have a good health care.
First patient I told on the 16 years old, penkin alle uber pekini po ainde session and the wife and the makko and the family and the friends so ellarnya putti kodunati ilaki idu kodukunnade nalla treatment aanalla.
3 years back, when my corporate world got end, I quit from corporate world, my insurance benefits also got an end, even with my family's too. At the same time, somebody referred me about Manipal Arogya Card. I feel thanks to the person who referred me. And recently, when my mother went into a cataract operation, she had got excellent benefits, as well as when my brother had come down from Gulf, he didn't had any insurance cover from there. So he is also, he had some gastro issues and things like that. That point of time also, this Arogya card came into very handy, and excellent benefits we got it. Manipal Arogya Health Card, I would say, which is coming in a very, very nominal cost, not even 10 rupees per day, which is an excellent, and it is affordable for anybody. Being in insurance industry, working for insurance industry, I know the importance of health insurance. The people who are having health insurance also can go for this. Why? Because most of the health insurance doesn't cover OP benefits. So here you will get excellent benefits.
Manipal Health Card and Malpa Yoka, you must help Pavandu. And card Malpa de Panaga Padra Padmujo showed in Chiani and the benefit get on the left. But can it pretty and jagla on the letter, discount for on the letter, admission of the Batana, medicine of the Batana, Boka Pratyunjila, Panaga doctor consult of pardon. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದೆಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ಸೆಷನ್ ಕೊರೊಂದಲ್ಲೇರಿ ಬಾಕ ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಅವು ನಂಗೆ ಇಂದಾನಗಾಮಕ್ಕೆ ರಿನಿವಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಲ್ಪರೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಎಲ್ಲ ಉಂಟು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ಬನಾಗ 50% ಈ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆನ್ಸಿ ಲೇಡಿನ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ಪೇರು ಬಂದು ಪನಂದ್ರ ಲೇರೆ ಮಸ್ತ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡು
ಅಮ್ಮಿ ವಿಂಗಡ ನಿಮ್ಗೂ ನನಿ ಪಳೆಯತ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸಂಗ್ಲೆ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಹೆ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಅಸ ಅಂತು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಅಸ ಅಂತು ತುಂಬೆಲ್ಲ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಕ್ಕ ನಿ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಕ ದೊಗ್ಗಂಕೆ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಕೊರೆ ತುಂಬ ಸಂಗ್ಲೆ ತಶಿ ಹೌತ ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಕಲ್ಲ ಅಂತು ಮೇಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅಜ್ಜಕ ಪ್ರೀ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಅಶೀಲ್ ನಿಮಿತ್ತ ಮಕ್ ಮಸ್ತ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಅಲ್ಕ ಸಮಳ ರೀ ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಜ್ಜಕ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟ್ಲ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಅವತ್ತಾನ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಫೀಸ್ ಅವರು ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಜೊತಶಿಲ ಅನಿ ತಕ್ಕ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬರೋಂದಿತ್ತನ ತಜ್ವೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಜೊತಶಿಲ ತಕ್ಕ ಎಕ್ಸ್ರೇ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತನ ತಜ್ವೆ ರೇ ತಂಕ ಮಸ್ತ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ತಶೀಶ್ ಮೇಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅನಮಕ ತಿಕ್ಕ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಶಿ ನಿಮಿತ್ತ ಆ್ಯಂಜಿಯೋ ಅನಿ ಕೊರ್ಕ ಮಳೆ ತದ್ನ ಮಸ್ತ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅನಿ ದೊಡ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಟೈಮಕ್ಕ ಮಸ್ತ್ ಅಮ್ಕ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಜಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ ಜನ ಸಂತೋಷ ಮಳೆ ಇತ್ಲಿ ರೀಸನಬಲ್ ರೇಟ್ ಅರ್ ಹೇ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲ್ತ ಸರ್ ತಶ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಕರಾಯಿತು ಮುಂದೆ ಮೇಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸಜೆಷನ್
ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಹಣ ಭರಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂತ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಂದ ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾಗಿದೆ ಬಡವರು ಎಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬಾ ಇದರದ್ದು ಸದುಪಯೋಗ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬಹುದು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನ ಅಂತರ ಇಲ್ಲ ಯಾರು ಸಹ ಪಡೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳಬಹುದು ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿ
ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್
Lakhs and lakhs of people have benefited by the Manipal Arogya card. It's about time we launched this card, and to do the honors now, we want Mr. Rahul Dravid to launch, unveil the Manipal Arogya card. Could we take it to the stage, please? Mr. Rahul Dravid, I want you to unveil and launch the Manipal Arogya card. Wishing you all truly. There it is, ladies and gentlemen, that's official. Manipal Arogya card unveiled by Mr. Rahul Dravid. Thank you.
ನನ್ನ ಬದುಕಿನ ಯಶಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಕಠಿಣ ಪರಿಶ್ರಮ ತಾಳ್ಮೆ ಗೌರವಿಸುವ ಗುಣವೇ ಕಾರಣ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕ್ರೀಡೆಯನ್ನ ತಾವಾಗಿಯೇ ಆಯ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕೇ ಹೊರತು ಹೆತ್ತವರು ಪೋಷಕರ ಒತ್ತಡ ಬಲತ್ಕಾರ ಹೇರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಸರಿಯಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕ್ರೀಡೆಯನ್ನ ವೃತ್ತಿಯಾಗಿ ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೂಡ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲ ಈ ಮಾತನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಮಾಜಿ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟಿಗ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್
ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ರಾಹುಲ್ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಬಂಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ದ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ enrollment of Manipal Arogya card for the year 2019-2020 so we would love it if you can hand it over to them yes and let me call the names welcome them with a huge round of applause these are the highest enrollment of Manipal Arogya card of the year 2018-2019 by these individuals let's hear it for Rakshit Kumar Shetty he has managed the highest enrollment of Manipal Arogya card for the year 2018-2019 well done Rakshit The next name is a very familiar name. George Fernandez. George Fernandez. On stage, George, director of St. Milagros Society. George Fernandez, thank you. Congratulations. K. Nityananda Nayak. K. Nityananda Nayak. Congratulations. Congratulations, Nityananda. Stay happy every day. Dinanitya Anandavagirin. Nityananda. Congratulations. Very well done. Next. Premavati. Premavati.
All the many dignitaries on the dais. Ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure to be here today and to spend the day here with all of you. I would really like to thank the Manipal Group, KMC Hospitals, for giving me the opportunity to be here at the launch of the Manipal Arogya Card. I think, as all of us know, healthcare today is becoming very, very expensive. It is something that is almost becoming beyond the reach of a lot of middle class and lower income group people. It's great pleasure that I've been given the opportunity to be here today to launch the Manipal Arogya Card, which makes healthcare, which makes a good quality of life, which is an absolute necessary for everyone, which is something that everyone actually deserves. It makes that affordable to so many people, and it touches and impacts so many people. So thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to be here. And congratulations to everyone in the KMC Hospital, in the Manipal Group, for the launch of the Manipal Arogya Card. I've really enjoyed my association and my partnership with the Manipal Group and Manipal Hospitals and Manipal Healthcare over the last year. It's given me the opportunity to see the fantastic work being done by the Manipal Group in places like Delhi and Jaipur, in Manipal, now here in Mangalore. It's given me the opportunity to meet and interact with some very, very interesting people. It's actually given me the opportunity to see the many lives that the Manipal Group touches in so many of its fields. It's a partnership that I really identify with. I'm proud to be associated with a group and a company that is always looking to push the boundaries, is always looking to provide, is always looking to challenge themselves, believes in excellence, believes in quality, believes in integrity, believes in ethics, and it's something that I truly identify with. So thank you so much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you so much for the warm welcome, and I've really enjoyed my time here in Manipal and in Mangalore. Thank you very much.
ಭಾರತ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ತಂಡ ಕಳೆದ ಎರಡು ವರ್ಷಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತಮ ನಿರ್ವಹಣೆ ತೋರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಈ ಬಾರಿಯ ವಿಶ್ವಕಪ್ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ಗೆ ಭಾರತ ತಂಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಯುವ ಆಟಗಾರರಿದ್ದು ತಂಡ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪಂದ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತಮ ನಿರ್ವಹಣೆ ತೋರಲಿದೆ ಎಂದು ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದರು.
I have been lucky and privileged to have been able to play sport as a profession. Lot of times I think people make the mistake of going into sport as young people, thinking that only if you want to make sport a career should you play sport. I think that is a mistake. I think you should play sport for the sake of playing sport, to enjoy sport, for so many other benefits that sport provides. If by doing that you're good enough and you're lucky enough to be very good at a particular sport, then yes, you know, I think you can look at it as a profession, you can look at it as a career. And the avenues for that are so many today. Is on an upswing. The opportunities for young sportsmen today are much more than they were even, say, 5 years ago or 10 years ago. The facilities, the opportunities, the infrastructure, everything is becoming better and better. So if you want to take up sport today, I think there are no excuses for people, either at a recreational level or at a slightly more professional level, if you so choose. So definitely my advice to young people and to their parents is, please go out, play the sport, use the opportunity to get the benefits of playing sport. And if you choose to make it a profession, then, you know, recognizing that sport is something, and the choice should always be not the parents' choice to choose whether their child should play cricket or football. I think a lot of times parents make the mistake of saying, I want to make my son a cricketer, or a lot of people come to me and say, how do I make my son Sachin Tendulkar? You know, I think that is, in my opinion, a mistake. The child should choose the profession, choose his sport, choose what he wants to do. And I think it's a responsibility of the parents then to encourage the choices that the children make. So the choice should always be with the young kids, and the parents should provide the support, and not vice versa.
Good evening, sir. My name is Sushma. Okay, my question to you is, what is that one value you hold on to dearly in your life? That's one value.
I can't think of one thing, but I think hard work and respect have been very, very important values for me in what I've done. I think, you know, I was lucky to be given the I was lucky to be able to play cricket quite well, or I was lucky to be given that opportunity. And I think, you know, one of the things I've been conscious of is not to take it for granted, to try to work really hard to become the best cricketer I can be, and really respect the fact that not everyone was given the gifts and the opportunities I got, and try and make the best of it. I think that's been very important.
Thank you very much, sir.
Rahul, we have a couch for you now.
Dangerous sitting in these things. Especially in my...
Yes.
Hello.
Hi. So, I have been your diehard fans ever since I started watching cricket, I think. I don't remember exactly since what age. So, my question to you is, when there are tons of people idolizing you across the world, who is that one idol that you look up to?
So I think, you know, growing up, my parents were a big influence on me, and the way they, I think the way they carried themselves and the way they conducted their lives, I think was a really good example for me to follow. So I would say they were my really first role models, along with my coach. My coach also was someone, I think, who epitomized what discipline, dedication, again, things like values and ethics meant, and so I was lucky to have role models like that growing up, whom I could follow and look up to. From the cricketing side, growing up, I was, you know, grew up always following people like Sunil Gavaskar and G.R. Vishwanath. They were my big heroes, people I looked up to. Kapil Dev was another one. I think his image of him lifting the 1983 World Cup is something that inspired me to play the game and play seriously. I was 10 years old then, so it was a huge inspiration for me. So. These were really my heroes sort of growing up, and people that I truly looked up to.
Thank you. Rahul, yes.
Name? Sir, my name is Sanjay.
Hi.
I'm a cricketer. My question to you is, if you were the Indian cricket captain, what will be your ideal team?
What will be my ideal team now?
Yes, for the cup.
For the?
World Cup.
For the World Cup? I think the team that's there is really good, you know. I think they've picked a really good team, and you know, I think I know there'll be a few debates here and there, and people might say, oh, he should have played, and maybe Rishabh could have played, and maybe someone else could have played, and you know. But I think that's the beauty of the talent in this country, that for one spot we have so many players and so many options. You know, no one is saying that, oh, where do we need to find players from? Everyone is saying, oh, he also can play, that guy can play. And I think that's a really good position to be in. So I think from now on, you know, we can have our doubts and we can have our discussions about who should play and who shouldn't play. But from now on, I think everyone, once the team has been picked, then I think we should just support the team and back the team in the World Cup.
Thank you. My name is Dr. Sharan.
Hi.
My question is related to anger management.
Anger management, okay.
How do you control your anger and try to be patient and calm enough?
No, it's not that I've never got angry, I must admit.
I can remember two incidents where you got angry. One was India-Pakistan match. You were taking a run and Shoaib Akhtar came in between.
Yeah.
So there was an exchange of words. I can recollect that. And one more incident was MTV Bakra, where they were playing prank against you and you got angry. So I can.
Yes, sir. Shoaib Akhtar is not difficult to get angry with. No, he was a good competitor and a very good fast bowler. I don't know. I mean, I honestly never thought about it. I guess I was a little bit lucky to be blessed with a slightly more relaxed temperament. You know, I don't remember even as a kid getting angry too often. I mean, I did get angry with my brother once in a while when he, you know, bothered me at home, like most families do, and most brothers and sisters have their fights. But no, I think just temperamentally, I actually also realized that, you know, when I got angry or if I got upset, you know, I was never able to perform to my best ability. Me staying calm and me staying relaxed actually got the best out of me. There are other players, you know, who when they get angry, they sometimes perform better. You know, they like that. So I think your own personality is very important. You know, I didn't want to be someone I was not. And for me, actually staying calm and relaxed worked really well. So I didn't think I needed to change it.
ಮಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಟಿಎಂಎ ಪೈ ಸಭಾಂಗಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಆಯೋಜಿಸಲಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಪಾಲ್ಗೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಇವರೆಲ್ಲರ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದೇ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಪಾಲಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಾ? ಹೀಗೆ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ರೀತಿಯ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳನ್ನು ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ನ ಮುಂದಿಟ್ರು. ರಾಹುಲ್ ಅವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಉತ್ತರ ಹೇಗಿತ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ.
ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಜಯ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್.
Good evening, Mr. Dravid. Big fan. It's a slightly unusual question. For me, Kevin Peterson is one of the best players who's played for England. He also seems to be a very difficult person to get along with because he seems to have fought with everybody. But in his autobiography, he devotes almost half a chapter to you, saying that he had so much difficulty with a particular type of bowling. And he's reproduced some of the emails that you exchanged and that you really helped him through a difficult time. So can you...
He was a terrific cricketer and very keen to learn and, you know, very keen to ask questions. And my time, I spent some time with him at RCB when, you know, we played together. And I think that was the beauty of the IPL. You got an opportunity to share the dressing room with... I know RCB is struggling at the moment, So you really got the opportunity to get to know people. And you know, just getting to know Kevin, I actually found him... I can't comment on why he had issues with other people. I mean, that's really none of my business and I don't know anything about it. But I actually found him very engaging, very, you know, keen to learn. He's obviously a fantastic batsman and, you know, one of the greatest batsmen that's played the game. You know, his range of shots and his ability to dominate an opposition was absolutely exceptional. The only conversation we had was a little bit about playing spin bowling and you know, what were the techniques and tactics I used to play, particularly left-arm spin bowling, you know, which he seemed to struggle with. And I just shared some ideas and thoughts with him on what worked for me, what I had been taught by my coaches. You know, so I just... And I think that was really... And I got to learn a lot from watching a lot of those people play as well. You know, I got to learn a lot watching Jack Callis in RCB or, you know, watching the way Dale Steyn carried himself in RCB or from someone like Kevin Peterson. So there was so much of learning that we were able to share, you know, across countries, across cultures, across nations through the IPL. And get to know people better. And I think that was one of the things, the beauties of, for me, for the IPL, you know, is that, sure, it's a great tournament and a lot of, you know, good cricket is played. But this opportunity to learn, I think it's like a university of, in some ways, 2020 cricket. You know, we are here in a university town. And a lot of you here will recognize the value in learning from interacting with people from different backgrounds, different cultures, different experiences. And a similar kind of thing happens at the IPL.
Thank you. Well, these are the questions we have received by people who dropped in these questions. Ashwini AS, can you speak anything in Kannada, please?
Nange khushi aayitu illi barakke nimm ellar jothe.
Thank you. I took the liberty of deleting the second part of the question because she wanted a selfie. If that starts, then everyone who wants a selfie. Okay, Akshat wants to know who inspired you to play cricket.
Not that he forced me to play the game, and he actually never pushed me to play the game, but he loved cricket. He genuinely loved cricket, and you know, he would always go to watch. Even if Karnataka was playing the Ranji Trophy and he had an off day on a weekend, my dad would go to the match, and as a young kid, you know, he would drag me along. You know, I would go with my father to watch international matches or Ranji Trophy matches. And, you know, he would, he listened to radio commentary. You know, in those days there was no television, but my father, you know, would be listening to radio commentary when India was playing in England or the West Indies. And, you know, he loved sort of telling me stories about Gavaskar and Vishwanath and a lot of these people. So, in some ways, I think that love of the game I sort of got from him. And, you know, just watching him and, you know, he kept playing club cricket in the 5th or 6th division till he was almost 45, 46 years old. And as a young boy, I remember tagging along to some of those matches and, you know, watching him play. But yeah, I think that was a great inspiration for me.
Okay, no name. Somebody wants to know if you have tried Mangalore ice cream.
Yeah, I've come to Mangalore when I was in college. So that's been over 25 years since I've come. And one of the first things that people told me about 25 years ago when I was coming here is you got to go and have Ideal's ice cream. And I'm glad to say that 25 years later when I came, people said the same thing. So obviously the brand is doing pretty well and the ice cream is really good. But yeah, 25 years ago I could eat what I wanted without worrying about it. But 25 years later I have to think about some things, you know. And the doctors, I've been to doctors the whole day, so they've told me, be careful what you eat.
Ashutosh asks you, what do you find common in medical career and cricket career?
What do I find common? I found it so common that I married a doctor.
Yeah!
I was never going to get into medical college for sure with my marks. So I did the next best thing, you know, so just some reflected glory. But what's the commonality? I think a lot of the medical profession is a lot tougher. I mean, we make mistakes. Yeah, it's bad, but you know, it doesn't cost lives. A lot of you make some mistakes, sometimes it can cost lives. So I have a lot of respect for that and for a lot that, you know, the medical profession goes through. But over and above that, I think, the thing about, I'd say that in any profession, I think it's about, you know, trying to get better all the time. It's trying to improve, it's trying to learn from your mistakes. And I think that's a lot about the medical profession is about as well. It's not that we'll never make mistakes, but you know, the people who stand out are the people who actually learn from those mistakes and move on.
Dr. Hansraj, you had a question.
Hi, Ravi. I'm Dr. Hansraj. For a change, we'll have a quiz question for you.
Okay.
What does Rahul Dravid share in common with Sunil Gavaskar, Alistair Cook, Mark Taylor, Desmond Haynes?
Mark Boucher. Oh, okay. We were all boring batsmen. Sorry, Mr. Gavaskar. Oh, sorry, Mr. Cook. But well, geez, you got me stumped there.
And then I'll bring on Brendan McCullum.
Brendan McCullum?
Yeah.
Okay, the boring part actually gets then deleted. Oh, God. I'm sorry,
it's a bouncer, right?
Sorry?
It's a bouncer.
Yeah, this was a big one.
Okay. You're the only cricketers who have played more than 100 test matches, but taken only one test wicket.
Oh, okay. Good one. It's pretty good company to be in, though. Thank you. I never thought about that.
Okay.
It's a one wicket I value very much as well. sorry? Yeah, Ridley Jacobs. When you take one, you remember that.
Good evening, Rahul.
Good evening.
My name is Alden. And my question is, how did you manage during your school days to balance your studies and sports together?
Yeah, I think it's a really good question. And I think one of the things that, I was very sort of lucky and fortunate to have is that, you know, I had really good teachers in school and in college who I think, you know, really supported my love of the sport and the fact that the sport kept me away from school and college for long periods of time. You know, when we played matches, sometimes I would go two months without going to college, you know, 2.5 months. But yeah, I was very lucky when I went back to school, the college, the principal, were very supportive of that and, you know, would actually encourage me and challenge me that I should not let my studies drop because of education. I think the main important thing is the word I use is balance. It's finding that ability to... I think if you choose a career in sport, then I think you have to make some sacrifices in some other areas. So I think, you know, some of the things like going out with your friends or going to movies and going and having Ideal's ice cream and spending 1 hour there, you know, things like that you might have to sacrifice, if you want to balance both your sport and studies, because it's not easy and it's getting tougher and tougher nowadays to balance both sport and studies. But I think it's critical that people try and do that. And I always encourage sportsmen and all the young cricketers that I coach is that they must try and study. And I think it does help as well in your sport, because if you can get discipline to be able to sit with your books and study, surely you can be disciplined on a cricket field and bat for a long period of time. So
super. Thank you. Yes.
Hi, sir. My name is Adarsh. So my question to you is, sir, how do you motivate yourself? Like, if you had a bad innings the previous day, what keeps you moving forward the next day?
Enjoying what is for me the most important thing. I love playing cricket. I enjoyed playing the game. And so I understood the fact that there would not always be good days. There would be some tough days. And I think the whole... I loved being a cricketer, I enjoyed being that, and I understood that the ups and downs was part of life, was part of being a cricketer, and loving what you do. And I think the same thing about coaching. You know, I get up today and I really look forward to coaching young people and young players, and not every day as a coach is great, and I can't honestly say that every day is I'm as enthusiastic as the other day, but more often than not, just loving what you do, I think is great motivation and a great source of sort of inspiration. To get up every morning and to be able to do something that you love.
Sir, this is Manjunath, your great fan. Sir, we have seen you as a player and then vice captain, captain, under 19 coach. When will you see you as a senior team coach?
Ravi Shastri is doing well. Yeah, why can't kick him out? Poor fellow. Look, I'm enjoying what I'm doing at the moment, and I have no intentions at the moment of, Also, I think coaching comes with its challenges. I've spent so many years traveling and being out of home so long that I have to manage and balance that as well.
Sir, and one more thing. Who do you think will win the World Cup?
Who do I think will win the World Cup? I'm hoping India will. We're all keeping our fingers crossed. Obviously, a lot of the... young players have gone from the Indian A team and the under 19 team and now are there in the senior team. So, yeah, really wishing and looking forward to the fact that hopefully India can win the World Cup. Keep our fingers crossed.
Mangalurina TMA Paisa Bangladali, Samvada Karikramavana, Ayusalagito. A Karikramadali, Sakashtu, Vidyartigalu Kuda, Palkotitro. Ivrellara, Prashnegalu Kuda, one day agito. Politics Ikihoktira, Atwa, Sports Minister Akthira. ಹೀಗೆ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ರೀತಿಯ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳನ್ನ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ ನ ಮುಂದಿಟ್ರು. ರಾಹುಲ್ ಅವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಉತ್ತರ ಹೇಗಿತ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ.
ಗುಡ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ರಾಹುಲ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಾನು ಕಿರಣ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಯು ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಆನ್ ಜಾಯ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಲಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್? ಯು ಮೈಟ್ ನೋ ದಿಸ್.
ಐ ಮೀನ್, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ, ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಕೋಚ್, ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ನೋ, ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ನೋ ಚಾನ್ಸ್, ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ. Politics, though, no chance.
Good evening, sir. I'm Kostov. I just wanted to say that you have been a part of Under-19 India coach, RCB, then Rajasthan Royals. Sir, the players who play university cricket and intercollegiate level cricket, sir, do they have a future for the professional cricket?
If you're good enough and you work hard enough, everyone has a dream and you should pursue your dreams. But it's not easy, and it requires a lot of hard work. It requires a lot of luck as well. You know, sport is slightly different from studies. You know, in studies you can study very hard, you can dedicate hours and hours to studies, and you might not be able to, every time get 100%, but you will definitely get good marks if you put in the effort. Sometimes in sport it doesn't work like that. Sometimes you can work very hard in sport and the results don't come. That is the nature of sport. That is the inherent risk involved with sport. Injuries are so much part and parcel of the sport that we play. So there are no guarantees in sport, unfortunately. But there's no doubt that if you have talent, if you have a dream, if you're willing to work hard, and if you're realistic about your abilities, the sky is the limit.
Well, which is one of the best innings of your life you want to talk about? Ever best innings of your entire cricket life?
I don't know. I mean, I there are two or three of them. I think, I've played a long time, so it's very hard for me to pick one. Obviously, the 180 and the partnership with VVS Lakshman in Calcutta is, something that was very special in the context that it was there. You know, scoring a 200 in Adelaide when we, you know, won in Australia after a long time, again something that gives me a lot of satisfaction. A couple of innings that I didn't score 100, you know, it's only a couple of 50s in Jamaica on a very bad wicket to win a test series in West Indies. Again, something, you know, that gave me a lot of satisfaction, a 270 in Pakistan. You know, so it's, I guess it's hard to pick one. It's very difficult to do that in your career. So, but every time, you know, you played an innings that helped the team win a match, I think they were always special innings because, you know, when you won a game for your team, you got to celebrate it with the whole team and it was a great occasion. I mean, if you scored 100 and you lost, it never felt the same. So every time I scored 100 and we were able to win, I think that gave me the greatest satisfaction.
Hi, Rahul.
Hi.
I'm Stephen. Just one question. What was the key to your mental toughness? We saw you persevere in some of those very difficult matches, stayed calm. So what was the key to your mental toughness?
I love the challenge of a contest. So for me, when I found myself in a difficult situation or a tough situation, I think sort of instinctively my mind thought of it as an opportunity and not so much as a threat. So I you know, I love the fact that when things were tough, you, even if I didn't always succeed, you know, when things were tough, or I didn't always succeed when the pressure was on, or I didn't always succeed when I needed to. I mean, you know, you fail a lot in cricket. But what I do remember is I loved that I got a buzz out of being in those situations, and I loved competing. You know, I loved competing, and in a sort of positive way. It was not that I hated someone, but I loved being in a contest, and the better the opponent was, I loved being in that contest. So I think that to me was a very important part of my ability to play long innings or to fight it out or to do well in difficult situations or the longevity of my career as well. It really was, for me, was a little bit about the fact that I loved the contest. I loved being in the middle of a contest.
Yep.
Hi, sir. I'm Danush. Welcome to Mangalore, sir. Yeah. Sir, my thing is when it comes to the matter of success, whole team will get appreciation, but when it comes to the matter of failure, only captain will be the blaming. You can correlate this question with cricket as well as corporate life. How can you sort out this, sir, especially in 2007 World Cup?
Yeah, but that's the beauty of being in the pointy end, no? That's the challenge of being a captain, and that's the responsibility that comes with being a captain. Sometimes you get blamed for things that you know, you probably don't deserve, but that is it. And I mean, if you are in leadership and if you are in management, you've got to be ready for that. I think, you know, you've got to be ready to accept that's part and parcel of being a leader. But if you do well, you know, and if you're able to succeed, then you can bring a lot of joy and happiness to so many people's lives. So, yeah, I think if you accept leadership and you accept positions of responsibility, then, you know, it comes with the job.
Little Adit has a question. Yes.
Hi, sir. My
Hi.
Name is Adit.
Hi.
I'm a surfer. I want to ask you one question. Which sport would you choose other than cricket?
Which sport would I choose other than cricket? So I played hockey in school. I used to play a lot of hockey in school. And at St. Joseph's Boys High School, we had a very strong hockey team. In fact, a couple of my, you know, people I played with, my colleagues in the hockey team, went on to play for India, played in the Olympics. And I used to play, you know, hockey with them. So I love playing hockey. I love team sport. So I was very much a team sport person. I love playing a team sport because I loved, I just loved the camaraderie, the friendships, everything that came with, you know, sharing, for example, failure and success with the team. So I loved a team sport. So if I couldn't play cricket, I probably would have tried hockey.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good evening, sir. I'm Pranav.
Good evening.
Huge fan, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, my question is, from playing with the likes of Sachin Tendulkar and VVS Lakshman to coaching Rishabh Pant and all, what's the change in mindset of the current cricketers?
Yeah, it's a huge change. I mean, in the sense that a lot of the boys today have grown up with, you know, 2020 cricket. They grow up with one day cricket. Their attitudes, you know, are very different in terms of how they approach a game. A lot more of the game is now about attack. A lot more about the game now is about being aggressive. So you have to coach differently from the way I played. You know, I was coached very differently. I was coached to keep the ball on the ground, not hit the ball in the air. You know, I can't tell that to Rishabh Pant today, right? So I think you've got to change with the times, and you've got to understand that, you know, people like Sachin and Lakshman and myself, we grew up in a different era. We grew up in a different generation. We grew up when test cricket was the most important form of the game. Today you have three formats of the game, so you had to coach like that. You know, I don't coach like the way I was coached. I like to believe the way or the current generation needs to be coached, which is they need to learn how to play three formats of the game and equip them for all the three formats of the game.
Thank you, sir. Rahul, whether you like it or not, I'll keep reminding you to sit down.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Nanu Sunil Attar, Mangalore inda. Nimge Mangalore ge swagata. ನಂದೊಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕಾಂಟ್ರವರ್ಸಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಇನ್ 2004 ಮುಲ್ತಾನ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಸಚಿನ್ ತೆಂಡೂಲ್ಕರ್ 194 ಇದ್ದರು, ಆಗ ನೀವು ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟನ್, ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ?
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್. ಯು ನೋ, ಲುಕ್, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಐ ಡಿಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಫೆಲ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೀಮ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ, ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ I didn't know the match will finish in 4 days. If I had known the match would finish in 4 days, I would definitely have not declared. But, you know, I felt that we needed the time to win the game. And, yeah, and I mean, the good thing about that is that, you know, I think you can agree to disagree, but Sachin and me are still friends today. And we might not agree on everything. We might not agree on stuff, you know, but it's been a long time. And that fact that we can be still friends, that means that we respect each other. So, you know, it's a long time.
Okay, last two questions, Rahul. Yes.
Good evening, sir. Myself, Adit. You have crashed many bowlers in your life. Who was the toughest pacer and spinner you have faced in your life?
Toughest?
Pacer and spinner.
Oh, the toughest fast bowler that I faced from the opposition would be, I think, Glenn McGrath. You know, I played Glenn McGrath at the best of his career, and he was a fantastic bowler. Great consistency, great skill, good speed. And someone who was aggressive all the time. And as a spinner, I think it'd have to be Muthiah Muralidharan. I think he spun the ball more than anyone I've seen. He had a lot of variations, he had incredible stamina, and he was at you all the time. So yeah, I'd say McGrath and Muralidharan are the two greatest bowlers I played against.
Okay, we'll wrap it up with the last question from the lady.
Being very lucky. Sir, Rahul sir, this is Lyra. I have two questions for you. Who is your favorite bowler to bat against, and do you enjoy playing cricket or coaching the young cricketers?
Okay, who was my favorite bowler to play against? My favorite bowler to play against was anybody who gave me a boundary. Anyone who gave me a half volley, I loved.
I want a name.
I'd say I enjoyed playing teams like Australia or teams like South Africa, because they had some very, very good bowlers, and they challenged you and they really pushed you and they forced you to get the best out of yourself. You know, I think any bowler that challenged you and forced you to get the best out of yourself, you really enjoyed playing, because even if you didn't succeed, you know you had improved. You know, so for me that was really important. And your second question was, sorry? Do I enjoy playing or do I enjoy coaching? I think I love playing. Coaching sometimes, you know, you're sitting there and the match situation gets tense or things are not going your way. You can't put your pads on, sadly, and you can't go out and play. But as a player, sometimes you could change the course of a game with your performances. So I love coaching, and don't get me wrong, I really enjoy it at this stage in my life because I can't play. But I love playing more.
Okay, last question from Nikship. Go for it, Nikship.
Hello, sir. Myself, Nikship, and I'm a cricketer. Sir, my question is, what were the tips you used to stay long in the crease?
You have to spend a long time in practice. If you want to spend a lot of hours in the crease, then you have to spend hours and hours on a cricket field. When you get the opportunity, keep playing well, don't get out, learn how to bat for long periods of time. Sadly, there is no secret formula or mantra. It's the good old-fashioned hard work, nothing else.
If it was a pleasure meeting the wall, ladies and gentlemen, how about a thunderous round of applause and cheers for Rahul Dravid. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Rahul, we have something from us to you with a lot of love. We have a memento. Thank you.
Send Tata bye-bye to Rahul Dravid.
ಒಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಹುಲ್ ದ್ರಾವಿಡ್ ಅವರು ಸರಳತೆಯನ್ನು ಮೈಗೂಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಿರುವ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಸಾಧನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಆಟಗಾರರಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ತುಂಬುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಇನ್ನಷ್ಟು ಉತ್ತಮವಾದ ಕೆಲಸ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿ ಎಂದು ಆಶಿಸುತ್ತಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಮುಕ್ತಾಯಗೊಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದು ಈ ಹೊತ್ತಿನ ವಿಶೇಷ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ. ನಿರಂತರ ಸುದ್ದಿ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಮನರಂಜನೆಗಾಗಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ ವಿ4 ನ್ಯೂಸ್. ಇದು ಮುನ್ನುಡಿ ಮುನ್ನಡೆಗಾಗಿ.